to the channel. Today we're gonna pick up a new tool. You know, with the 68, it's got a lot of oxidation on it. Today I wanted to pick up a polisher, some pads, some good compound, some sandpaper. We're gonna get to that 68, we're gonna polish it down, see if we can make that guy shine today. So we're gonna go ahead and let's just head out over to the store and pick up that polisher. Yes, sir, and here it is, 7-piece car polishing kit. Let's see what it comes with. So we got a 11-amp motor, 600 to 3,000 RPMs, variable speed, standard hook and loop, includes polishing pad. Looks like we're good. Looks like we're gonna have to get another polishing pad and let's get some compound. All right, guys, we got our polisher and we have our 8-inch professional wool bonnet, fits 7-inch hook and loop backer pads. So that's what we got. And so let's go get some sandpaper. All right, guys, we got our polisher, we got the bonnet. They didn't have any sandpaper, so we're gonna have to go somewhere else to get some sandpaper and some polish. So let's go grab it. All right, second stop, Advanced Auto Parts. All right, let's see what kind of compound they got here. You know, I think the 1500 should be good. Yeah, 1500 should be good. Yeah, I'm gonna try this one out. All right, guys, we got everything we needed. I went with Chemical Guys compound, and we got our 1500 sandpaper. And so let's get back over to the house and see what we can do. All right, guys, we're back at the house. Let's get this thing unboxed. Let's go ahead and let's open this guy up here. Nice. Oh, nice carrying case too. That's nice, fit on the shelves. Oh, this is nice. Nice bag. Instructions. Here's our pads, our foam pads. Tightening and handle. Okay. For the disc. There's another one. For Velcro. There we go. Some nice cloths. And a small wool one. Just gonna put this down. Here we go. This is nice. All right, guys, like we said, this is a multi-speed. Looks like it goes from 1 to 6, and we have our speeds here. So 1 is 600, 2 900, 3 1500, all the way up to 6, which is 3000. There we go. So that's nice. Here's our trigger, and I'll just pop it off as well. Looks nice. Looks like something we can work with here. We got our handle and our tool to secure things. Now, I've never used one of these, so this is gonna be interesting. Newbie. All right. Now, I've used an angle grinder, so it's like a giant angle grinder.
All right, guys, I am going to read the directions a little bit here, and I will come back and we'll go through this real quickly. So, so here we got our polyfoam pads. We got two of these. We have our synthetic wool bonnets in here. And we have our microfiber pad as well. We have our hook and look, right? Backer pad. So I think this is what everything sticks onto. And our six microfiber towels. So that's nice. So from the directions that I was reading, basically what we have to do, it says it's a simple install. So this does not just spin. So what we have to do is we have to push this guy first and then spin it on. There we go. So this locks it, locks the nut here, and we can tighten that guy on. So this is good to go. So with these being Velcro, they'll stick right on here. So at the store, remember, we purchased this as well. I looked on the internet, and we got an 8-inch professional wool bonnet. It fits the 7-inch hook and look backer pads. So those are all the components that we got with this guy. Now, I'm gonna get started to use this. All right, guys, today's gonna be a get down and dirty day. So we're gonna see if we can polish this hood. Now, this is an experiment for me. I've never done this before, but I do have another hood that we're gonna put on. So I'm not worried if I jack this hood up right now, but I don't think I'm gonna jack it up. I think it's actually gonna come out pretty nice. So the first thing we wanna do is go ahead and wash off the hood. I'm just gonna do probably about a 2 foot by 2 foot area first. So let's take a look at the paint first and see what we're dealing with. Okay, so we're in the garage here, so we can actually kind of see what we're dealing with the paint here. So as you can see, there's a ton of oxidation on this hood. Here's the side panels too. It's just kind of dirty, but it just doesn't have any gloss, right? There's no sheen. That's actually, that actually looks kind of like a camera trick because it's not even glossy at all. So what I'm gonna do is I got my bucket, soapy water. I'm gonna go ahead and wash this down. Then what we'll do is get the sandpaper, 1500 grit. We'll go through and in just a up and down motion, side to side, just this area here on the hood. And after that, we'll get some compound with the polisher, go over that guy and see how it comes out. All right, first things first, let's go ahead and wash down the hood. Got some clean microfiber towels. I gotta put a link in the description for these guys. I got these on Amazon. Look at the size of these. These are great. All right, so we cleaned this guy off. It's super clean now, but of course it comes back and it dries to a real white haze. So let's get the sandpaper. Just go over this right here and see how that comes off. And maybe we can get some of this grit off of here because it looks disgusting. All right, guys, all links are gonna be in the description. So here's what we got. Chemical Guys, Clear Cut Correction Compound, right here. Remove scratches, rain etching, severe swirling, holograms, and 1200 grit. So we got 1500 grit, so we should be okay. So we're gonna run the 1500 grit sandpaper on here. And with this compound, it should be able to buff it out. When I'm sanding here, I can see where we have the dirt, the oxidation that's on this hood here. So I'm gonna keep sanding until I get that stuff off. Once I do that, I'm gonna stop. I'm not gonna keep going because I don't wanna go through the paint. But then again, we have the new hood, so, you know, if it does kind of jack it up, you know, at least we got the new hood to put on. So let's give this a try. So you want to be real careful also in these valleys and the ridges of the hood or any other body panel, because it's really, it'll be real easy to skin off the paint right here on the ridge. So I don't want to do that. Smoother. Oh man, it's a heck of a lot smoother. I think I could use a little bit more up here, sand a little bit more there, but I mean, just the to the touch itself, it is nice and smooth. So I'm gonna see if I can sand a little bit more and see how that comes out. We got our hook and loop on. Let's get the bonnet on here and plug this bad boy in. There we go. All right, so from what I saw, it was dab, dab, dab. Yeah, that's probably way too much. So, what I'm going to do is go 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. All right, here we go. Alright guys, so here you can see the oxidation, and over here, ooh man, this is nice and smooth. I mean, the paint isn't perfect, you know, it's got some, still has some stuff in the paint, it looks like, but it sure is nice. Looks nice, nice and shiny. So I think overall, it did a great job. Well, there you go guys. I think we had a good success. It looks great. I think I'm actually kind of tempted to do the rest of the car, but maybe not today. We'll see how that goes. But if I do, I'll go ahead and post it, you know, just kind of a quick video of me just doing it, so that we already have the tutorial of how to do it. And so here, get to show you kind of the end product. So again, go ahead and look up that polisher that I got. I got this on Northwest Tools, I think it was. I'll put the link down in the description. Chemical Guys compound, 1500 grit sandpaper. You got your bucket with your soapy water. And after that, you just got to go to town. So, hey, thanks guys. Again, like, subscribe. Always trying to bring you new content on the channel. Again, we got the hood. We got the trunk lid back over there that we're going to install. My wife's actually going to help me with that guy. And she's actually going to do the tutorial and step you guys through that. So you might need some subtitles on that. Again, guys, hey, thanks a lot. Y'all have a great weekend. Peace.